Alright, so earlier this week I depotted my Urban Decay Primer Potion into this little pot. As you can see, there's like a ton of product in there. I'm gonna apply some of this onto my lid because I find that Urban Decay Primer Potion is a little bit stickier than Too Faced Shadow Insurance. And I want a sticky base so that these colors really adhere. You can also apply it under your eye. I don't have any concealer on under my eye yet because these colors are so bright, there's likely going to be a little bit of fallout. So I just will put my under eye concealer on afterwards. So first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my Coastal Scents 88 matte or 88 regular palette. I'm going to grab this Chartreuse color right here. So it's in the third row and it's the third color down. So right there. I really love this color. It's the color that's in like the middle of the lid right there. But the way that I did this, I'm actually going to apply it all over my lid to begin with. And you want to pat it on so that it goes on really bright. If you have like the perfect colored base for this, then you could definitely put that under, but I unfortunately do not own a Chartreuse colored base, so I just am working with what I have, but it still works pretty well when you just use the Urban Decay Primer Potion. It's pretty bright still. Next what I'm going to do is something I probably should have done earlier, but I'm going to take a piece of scotch tape, just about this big, and I'm going to put it on the back of my hand to get rid of some of the stickiness, so it's not too sticky, and then I'm going to stick it on my eye in the same angle as the other eye had. Just kind of got to make sure you're getting the right angle between both eyes. It's easier if you do both tapes at the same time, but of course I did this eye earlier, so I wanted to show you. I've done a lot of videos with tapes on tape on my eye before, but I just wanted to show you in case everybody, making sure everybody knows how. Next I'm going to take this second color from the bottom here, this one right there, and I'm going to take my MAC 217 brush. And I'm going to apply that into my crease like I normally would. And I'm just going to blend that out. So when I've got it all blended out so it looks something like this, it does take a while if you want it to look perfect. I'm going to take a small crease brush like this one, and I'm going to take this darkest color down here in the same row. So all these greens are from the same row so far. And I'm going to apply that just in my outer V just to deepen it up and add a little bit of dimension to the look. And again, you want to blend that out. I'm just going to use my SS 224 and blend that so that it is really well blended. You don't want to blend it too far into like the middle portion of the eye. What I did with this side to blend it a little bit better is I took that Chartreuse color onto my 224 and I blended it over the rest of the colors and up onto my kind of just below my brow bone. Just lightens everything up a little bit. Okay, so next I'm going to take this Low Carnal 1/4 inch Maxine's Mop Brush that I got at Michael's. And it's smaller than, like a lot smaller than my flat shader brush that I used originally. So it'll be a lot more precise and easier to work with. I'm going to take that first green color, or not the first green color, this one that's second from the top, and I'm going to apply that, just take a very little bit of on the tip of the brush, and apply that actually on my inner corner. And you want to make sure that you tap the brush off really well, because you don't want to get too much. And fallout already. So as you can see, I'm connecting it right here with the rest of that green color. Just like that. And I'm going to keep just blending it in a little bit. And you can take your shader brush and blend that out as well. And I'm just going to take that darkest green color from the very bottom, and I'm just going to apply it just in the very inner portion here and connect it up. And then I'm going to go over that with blending brush as well. And as you can see, I just blended it a little bit far on the inside here. It's hard not to with such a large brush. But we'll clean it all up after. Okay, so right now I'm looking pretty crazy. But first thing I want to do to clean up the look is I'm just going to clean up the inner corner right here with a little bit of makeup remover on a cotton pad, or on a cotton swab, sorry. We want that area to be a lot brighter. I'm gonna do that on both sides, just all the way around. I'm going to clean up fallout underneath as well. So after that's dry, I'm just going to wipe off this 224 brush, and I'm going to take this matte white color in the corner of the palette, and I'm going to apply that to both my brow bones. And this is something that is good to just even it up if one side's too high or something like that, and it'll fix any mistakes and it'll blend out that final bit of color. So just right along there. Alright, so now I'm going to take off the tape. And clean that up. I'm very messy when I work, but you can always clean it up. It's makeup, it's not permanent, so that's good. Now I'm going to take that little brush again, and I'm going to take the medium green color, the one that's mostly in our crease, the one that's second from the bottom. I'm going to apply that underneath. In a very thin line. Only 2/3 of the way in. Just like that. And then I'm just going to take an angled brush like this with that chartreuse color, that light green, and I'm going to apply that on the inner 1/3 underneath. Alright, Now for eyeliner, we're done with the shadow finally. That took a long time. I'm gonna take my trusted and true L'Oreal Lineur Intense Carbon Black liquid liner, my holy grail eyeliner of all time, as I've mentioned in countless videos. I'm going to do a winged eyeliner today because this is a dramatic look and I might as well go with it. I'm gonna go and do the wing on the same angle as the eyeliner. Or as the eyeshadow, sorry. So now I'm just gonna curl my lashes, apply mascara, and I'll be back to show you what's on the rest of my face. Okay guys, so I'm back. Basically, I completely forgot to tell you guys to line your lower waterline with black eyeliner. I used this Maybelline Eyestudio black gel eyeliner because it lasts really well on the waterline. And I also tightlined my upper lash line with that and applied two coats of mascara. You could most definitely apply false lashes with this look. It would look really good. I am not going anywhere. I'm just going to wash this off later. So there's no point in me applying false lashes with this. But basically, because the eyes are so bright, you want to use a blush that is pretty subtle and hopefully a little bit cool toned because the eyes are so cool toned. So I'm just using this very light pink blush from e.l.f. Studio called Tickled Pink. And I'm just going to apply that really lightly to the apples of my cheeks. So it's like hardly even noticeable. For my lips, I just have a little bit of this Hard Candy Glamoflauge Concealer on the back of my hand. I'm just going to take a very small amount of that and apply that to my lips because as you can see, my lips are very, very pigmented and I don't want them to stand out because the eyes stand out so much. So just like that, and then I'm just going to take this gloss from NYX, it's called Sorbet, it's one of their round lip glosses. I'm just going to apply that to my lips just so that they're very subtle looking. Nothing too crazy, it's just a very light, shimmery, kind of sparkly pink color. So that is the finished look. I hope you guys really enjoy these dramatic green eyes. I figured I would do something a little bit more artistic because so many of my videos are like neutral looks that you can wear to work or something like that. And I am a makeup artist, so I do like to play around with makeup and wear. I might not wear this out of the house to school or something like that. It's really fun to do, and if you're going to a party or something or like going out to a nightclub, you could definitely do something like this to kind of change it up. So I hope you really enjoyed this dramatic look and stay tuned for more videos. Have a really great day. Bye guys!